Welcome to Deja View, where each week we flash back over 17 years of programming on the school channel. I'm your host and resident old guy, Gary Kramer, and with me are Amy Marsh.
Hi.
And Diane Stowe.
Hello.
And on today's show, we're going to finish the soap opera that premiered on the school channel in 1986, the Token Soap, and then we're going to move forward to 1994, which was a very good year for the school channel and a very good year for talent at Norman High.
Last week's Token Soap Marathon left us on a cliffhanger that rivals the classic Who Shot J.R. in Dallas. Who's Mr. Untouchable and why is Nathan Luger afraid of him? Will Veronica run for city council? What's to be done with the case of sibling rivalry between Katrina and Cassandra? Does anybody really care? Let's see, if any, of which questions are answered in the final episode of 1986's Token Soap.
Luger makes a phone call.
It's me. Listen, and listen carefully. You screwed up again, but we have one more chance. Listen. Remember your training. Forget Vladimir. I repeat, forget Vladimir. Your new target is Olaf Svensson. I repeat, Olaf Svensson. The target will cue you. Repeat, the target will cue. The cue will be, pleased to meet you. Repeat, pleased to meet you. Now, kill.
That was rough. I'm exhausted. I need some. It's safe. Oh.
Mr. Untouchable's on line one.
Dwight.
Nathan here. Yes, sir. Yeah. It's taken care of. I guarantee. That's rather strange. No, I don't mean to question you. Of course not, no. Absolutely, I can be there. I'm on my way now. Yes, sir. Thank you for calling.
Mr. Untouchable, the contractor is taking care of the building.
Meanwhile, Stephen is on the midnight plane to Louisville.
This is your captain speaking. We'll be landing in 20 minutes. We are experiencing some minimal turbulence. Please remain calm. We are right now heading into a nosedive. Please remain calm.
Meanwhile, Cassandra is having a conversation with her twin sister, Katrina.
Kristen, the other day after the maids cleaned Calvin's room, I was in there doing some tidying up, and I found something.
And what could that be, Cassandra?
I think you know.
I haven't the foggiest idea what you're talking about, sister dearest.
I found this letter that you wrote to my husband, Calvin, and signed it, Love and Kisses, Katrina.
But you don't understand, Cassandra.
I think I understand all there is to understand.
You know I've always been your loving sister.
I know you've always been a husband-grabbing little tramp.
Calvin just married you because I had a date that night.
I'm going to take this letter and...
Thank you.
What has happened to Cassandra? Or is it Katrina? And which one of them was killed? Is Joey really a malicious hired assassin paid by Nathan Luger? And who will make it to the ground first? Nathan or Steven? And what has Veronica found in the attic? Or what has found Veronica? You'll learn the answers to these and many other questions in the next Token Soap.
Well, those questions and others will never be answered because that was the last episode of the Token Soap. But I enjoyed reliving that storyline and watching those people again. We had a good time in 1986 producing that after hours here in the studio. We also had a good time in 1994 as Norman Hyde talent came into the studio to perform in a show that we called Forum that year. Now, Forum has gone through several transformations, and now that particular show's format we refer to as Medium Well. So if you want to see the talent at Norman Hyde this year, watch Medium Well. But in 1994, the talent was in the Forum.
In the spring of 1994, the Forum was the place to be at Norman High. Students came to the Forum to exchange ideas, to strut their stuff, to educate, and to entertain. Chris Kalinske and Stefan Hadfield combined the education and entertainment as they welcomed performers from the NHS band to perform pieces they were taking to contest.
Thanks a lot.
Okay, our next performance is a soloist. And let me point out that soloist, you have to have your music memorized in order to be able to play. If you play with your music, you get an automatic two. Our next performance will be by Nathan Heim. He'll be performing on his marimba, and the piece is called Yellow After the Rain. Thank you. Oh, Nathan, that was a very fantastic performance. Very fantastic. Mr. Davison, I was curious if you'd care to elaborate on the way that...
Wow.
Yeah, Nathan Hines knew what he was doing, and I'm sure he's doing percussion somewhere. I think he got some scholarships for that. Yeah.
He couldn't even hold two of those things. He was holding four.
He's the man. And the other man was Chris Galinsky, who was host of that particular episode. Chris is now the Multimedia Cablevision Ringmaster for the City of Norman. He's attending OU. And you'll be seeing a lot more about Chris this year as he prepares for Red Ribbon Week.
Not all band members at Norman High School were found marching on the football field or competing for solo and ensemble contests. Bobby Johnson was a member of a different kind of NHS band, a garage band. Matt Burden welcomes guitar virtuoso Bobby Johnson into the Forum in 1994.
Norman High is named nationwide for its music program, but very few people know that we have a small number of amazing guitarists. One of them is Bobby Johnson. He's here today to demonstrate his talent for us.
Thanks everyone for joining us tonight. It's tough coming back from spring break, but remember, summer's just around the corner. For my co-host Matt Burden, I'm Colin Kimberly. Good night, everybody.
Mercy. Bobby Johnson must have spent a lot of time in that garage to be able to play like that. So now do you believe me? 1994 was a year of talent here at Norman High.
A forum was a part of a Roman city, sort of like a town square. But even though the forum has an urban background, when Summer Driscoll came in by in 1994, the forum took on a decidedly country atmosphere.
Made you say that?
Maybe tonight I'm gonna tell him how I feel. Maybe I'll leave well enough alone. Maybe, just maybe, he'll wanna be my baby. What if he's got plans of his own? Waiting for the perfect moment, looking for the perfect phrase. The one I finally choose is simply I love you. And as the words came out, I heard a voice inside me say, what made you say that? Was it the moonlight? Was it the starlight in your eyes? You've been listening to your heart. It's too late now. You don't want to take it back. Well, I know love's what made you say that. His reaction and a smile slow and spread across his face. Well, he said, what took you so long? That's what I've been waiting on. I thought you'd take forever and a day. What made you say that? Was it the moonlight? Was it the starlight in your eyes? You've been listening to your heart. Take it back, 'cause I know love's what made you say that. What made you say that? Was it the moonlight? Was it the starlight in your eyes?
What made you say that?
You've been listening to your heart. It's too late now, I won't let you take it back. Was it the moonlight? Was it the starlight in your eyes? You've been listening to your heart. It's too late now. You don't want to take it back. Well, I know love's what made you say that.
That was Summer Driscoll wondering what made you say that from a song she performed in the Forum in 1994.
During the same hour that one of the media classes was producing the Forum, the instrumental music department had its jazz band class. Several of the jazz band members were also media students. The NHS jazz band would often cross the campus to perform in the Forum. Here are the 1994 Norman High School jazz band heating things up in the Forum. Can you spot the media students?
Performing for you one more time is Norman High's outstanding jazz band.
Thank you.
That was the Norman High School Jazz Band rocking it out in the Forum in 1994. As I've said, a very good year for talent at Norman High. And on next week's Deja View, we're going to stay in the Forum, but it takes on a new name, and we welcome a new group of performers into the studio to show how talented the students are at Norman High School. So join us next week as we welcome some vocalists into the studio and share their talents with you. And we'll be here. So until then, for Amy Marsh and Diane Stowe, I'm Gary Kramer for Deja View. Good night.
Good night.
Good night.